Welcome back to Simply Fit. Remember, guys, our mission is to save 1 million lives by encouraging individuals to live a simply fit life through health and nutrition. And we do this by providing simple tips and strategies to individuals so that they're able to overcome suicide and depression. I'm Sandy White, your number one health and wellness cheerleader and the host of Simply Fit. And on today's segment, we have Miss Angela on, and she's going to be talking about her book, I Am Not Contagious. And this book is to help kids cope with school and social fallouts when their parents decide against vaccination. And this is a perfect time to be talking about this. But before we get into all of the juiciness and bring Miss Angela on, I do want to show my gratitude and tell WYTV7 Community Broadcasters Network, thank you, and more thank you for allowing Simply Fit to be on your platform. And guys, go to the website, WYTV7.org. Their mission is to educate, empower, and to encourage. And there's a plethora of things that is going on in the community. So check out what we're doing. It can bless you or someone else's life. So with that being said, I'd like to invite Miss Angela Pearson onto the show. How are you?
I am good. Thank you so much for having me, Sandy.
Oh, thank you. And as I mentioned before, this is a perfect time because we're in a pandemic, and now they're saying there's a Delta virus going on. There are children, they're just people beyond children that cannot take the vaccination for whatever reason. And a lot of us are in the same position. We did not have the bright idea that you did. So let's jump into, why did you make the decision that you made in reference to not having your younger children vaccinated? And then was that the catalyst for your book?
Yes. So, I've been a holistic enthusiast for 20 plus years. My oldest son is going to be 25 this year.
Wow.
And he's partially vaccinated. And I was a young mother. I was 17 when I had my first son. And, you know, I did everything that I was told to do by the doctors, you know, follow the CDC schedule, follow the vaccination schedule, do exactly what I'm supposed to do. That is, unfortunately, my son in his first life, in his first year of life, he actually had an adverse reaction to one of his vaccines, and he was hospitalized for 3 days. So that gave me the open-mindedness of, you know, going outside my comfort zone and really looking at other alternatives. And that's when my holistic journey began. That's when I started researching vaccine ingredients. That's when I started researching ingredients and foods. And then my daughter, she was born 4 years later, 4.5 years later. And that is when I made the decision that because of my older son having the reaction that he did, which led him in the hospital for 3 days, it just seemed right for me and my family to not vaccinate my daughter because I was scared. I mean, you can just imagine, you know, if your first son or your first child had a reaction to a vaccine, you know, and if I continued his vaccine schedule, what would happen to him? Like, would he have another reaction? And now I have another child. You know, I don't want my other child to have, you know, a reaction the way he did because it might be more severe. And now my youngest son, Grayson, who the book is about, he too has never been vaccinated. So he and my daughter is 20 this year, and my youngest son is 8, and neither one of them have ever had a vaccine. And my older son, like I said, he was partially vaccinated. And I stopped his vaccinations after that reaction. I was afraid to move forward.
You know, and that's really interesting that you said, because now with the vaccine, they're telling people what's in them and to be aware if you are allergic to them. Prior to, they were not sharing that with parents. They weren't sharing that with anyone. And it is very scary. And I am you know, just thrilled that you were able to come up with a solution, because a lot of folks feel trapped when they're in the situation, and they don't share that if your child has a reaction to a vaccine, you know, here are some alternatives. Mm-hmm. You don't have those alternatives. So I'm glad that you didn't quit. So when you made the decision that I'm not going to do any more vaccinations for my children, and you went holistic, what was the journey for that so that they could remain safe?
You know, so what I initially started doing is I actually asked for the vaccine insert. I started researching the ingredients, and then I started researching, you know, holistic ways to take care of our bodies and to build our immune systems. And there's so much that God has already given us. Anything that grows from the earth, God gave it to us because he knew that there were going to be sicknesses. He knew that there were going to be illnesses, and he knew that we needed to have a way to combat them. And which is why he gave us the herbs and the plants and the shrubs and the trees, so that we can utilize them to build our immune system. You know, one of the things to recognize is that the FDA cannot, the FDA, the pharmaceutical companies, no one can patent anything that comes from the earth. Okay. So this is why Big Pharma is so against herbal medicines and holistic alternatives, because it cuts into their profit.
I so agree with you on that. And now I know that the oil, the essential oils, are not the only thing that a person can use. It's the remedies and all of the different foods. The organic foods. Let me ask you this before we get into the book. Are there any particular recipes that you would suggest, or that you have, that you provide, that you maybe have an online workshop that you can provide to parents to just get started? Because going holistic works if you start it and you are continuous, you know, you're consistent with it. It's not a hit or miss thing. So is there some suggestions that you can provide to the parents right now, like mm-hmm. one or two or three options?
Yeah, I would start with the foods. You know, I think, you know, so for me, like, I eat only organic foods. And because the ingredients that they put in vaccines, they also put into our food sources as well. When we look at children, 5 and under, they are suffering with cancer. There's no reason why children should be suffering with cancer today. And we have to ask the hard question, how many of those children fighting with cancer, fighting for their lives with cancer, how many of them have been vaccinated? You know, a lot of people ask me all the time, or they tell me, you know, well, organic foods are expensive. They can be expensive, but we have to look at that as a health investment. You know, we tend to invest in either a nice pair of shoes, or we'll invest in a nice home, we'll invest in a nice car, maybe a nice purse or a bag or something like that. But we need to start investing in our health. So when you look at organic foods, or when you're looking at something, instead of looking at it as an expense or something that's expensive, look at it as a health investment that's going to create longevity in your life and in your children's life. Look at ingredients, stay away from high fructose corn syrup, artificial food colorings, and dyes, white sugars, white flours, and things like that. I would start with that first, and then just grab a vaccine insert and really start sitting down with your doctor and asking those hard questions. Also, you can join Facebook groups that, you know, parents get together and they talk about their reactions or their children's reactions to vaccines. I have a lot of resources on my Facebook page. Anyone looking to, you know, anyone who's in need of a religious exemption, especially now with everything that's going on with COVID, a lot of employers are mandating everyone to get the experimental jab. So if anyone is in need of help in regards to that, I can't guarantee you anything, but I do have a lot of resources. One of them is going to mykidsmychoice.com. That is not my website. That is another freedom warrior activist. Her name is Rita Palma. And she put a lot of these together along with a lot of attorneys to help people with religious exemptions so that they can maintain their jobs with their employers. For students who are going to college, because a lot of colleges are trying to mandate that as well. There are loopholes, and even military. You know, just because you're in the military, a lot of people think you're in the military, you give up your body to the government. That's not true. That's what they tell you. That's what they want you to believe. But there are loopholes with still using religious exemptions. Right now, currently, there are 5 states. And New York being the 5th state to jump on that bandwagon, who removed religious exemption for preschools on up to 12th grade, but it doesn't apply to colleges, okay? So in the same year that my son was banned, in 2019, he was entering the first grade. He was banned from attending any private or public schools, including a Montessori school. Like, I even tried to get him into a Montessori school, which is crazy expensive, but they wouldn't even accept him either because of how they file their school. And my daughter was entering college that same year in 2019. So the rules did not apply to her. She still was able to attend college with a religious exemption, even though my son couldn't.
Yeah, you know, it's a sticky situation. Not everybody's going to agree with, you know, personal decisions. Mm-hmm. And I know the decisions right now are masks across the country, and that's why they're doing what they're doing. But there are a lot of parents that are stuck, and I don't want to say it's a loophole. Like, we initially did not want to do the vaccination, but we went on and did it because I'm not in a position to stay at home. And then when they decided, oh no, we don't want you people here, stay at home, you know, we were like, well, we went and did this. And it's kind of tricky because you don't know until you have a situation like your son did. You go and you do something, and then you're vaccinated, and then you have this allergic reaction, and it's a hit or miss on how things are going to work. So let me ask you right now, because I heard you say that you couldn't do public schools or private schools, and we were able to do a private school. So one of my sons just turned 12. So he was able to, he hasn't gotten, but he can get vaccinated. But then my other one is 9. He cannot. And he's having anxiety challenges because he's like, I don't want to get sick. I don't want anybody else to get sick. And so what they're saying for children that cannot be vaccinated, you can wear your mask. But my only challenge is there's so many people like scrunched up in there. I mean, I'm actually having challenges because I'm not even sure if I need to do this or not. So with Grayson, you know, not being able to go to the first grade, how does it, because I'm telling you how it affected me and I'm not even in the first grade. How does that affect him? And how is it still affecting him that he cannot go and he was trying to go?
So at first, I think we might be talking about 2 different things, correct? So we're talking about childhood vaccinations, and then we're also talking about the COVID injection, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So my book is about childhood vaccinations, and Grayson has been going to school his entire life, okay? And, you know, being social and being involved in education was a big part of, you know, our family. So he's been going to school since he went to toddler school, he went to preschool, he went to kindergarten. And then here he is in the first grade, and he knew that he wouldn't be able to attend. I am so sorry. My birds are going crazy right now. Should I remove them?
No, let's do this. Let's take a commercial break. Put your book up real quick. I Am Not Contagious. We're going to be right back with it. We'll take a quick commercial break, and then we're going to have Angela come back on and talk a little bit more about I Am Not Contagious.
Happy Living here. I love good things made for good people. That's why I love Happy Living's online e-course. It's an 8-week long deep dive into you and the inspired life you want to live. The life you were put here on this earth to live. The one that you and only you can live. 8 weeks of lectures and ideas and topics and supporting materials and powerful self-improvement tools, all designed for you, all designed to help you create the tools and the power and the confidence you need to discover your purpose and to discover the life you were meant to live and to feel incredibly inspired and motivated to decide you will live your life to its fullest. It's all designed to help you create the unique and distinct philosophy of you and your inspired life. Go to happyliving.com, select our e-course, and save $100 with promo code WITV7. And for every enrollment, I'll donate another $100 to WITV7. For $300 and about 30 hours, I promise you'll never, ever be the same again.
Hey guys, we're back. I'm Sandy White, the host of Simply Fit, and we've been talking with Miss Angela Pearson. I'm going to have her put the book up, and Angela, you can just talk a little bit about what the importance and the mission behind the book is, and then we'll go with some more questions.
Absolutely. So this is my book. This is I Am Not Contagious, and this is my son, Grayson, and then right here is our used to be governor, Andrew Cuomo, who is no longer our governor, who just put in his resignation. And this is Grayson's school. And I really wanted Grayson, this is an inspirational book. This isn't anything negative. This isn't about my perspective. This is from, his perspective, because at the time he was just 6 years old. The way he sees things is a lot different than the way you and I would see things. We tend to put things on a scientific level. Whereas my son, he just knew that he couldn't go to school anymore to be with his friends, and he didn't understand why. He also knew that he could go to gymnastics and be with all of his friends. He also knew that he could go to the park and be with all of his friends. And also, we were a member of the YMCA, and he also was affiliated with a bunch of kids there, taking piano lessons and all that fun, fancy jazz. But he could be around all of the children there, but he couldn't be around the children in a school setting. So this was confusing for Grayson. And it's even confusing for us as adults. Like, we don't understand, he can be in all these other places, but he can't, go to school and get an education with his friends. So I think every child needs a book that they can relate to. Diversity is very important. And I think holistic children are no different. They need to understand, they need to know, they need to see themselves and realize that, because of their parents' holistic approach to vaccinations, there's nothing wrong with them. They're perfectly healthy. And we just take a different approach to vaccinations and to our immune systems. And I think the public lack that education because they're being misinformed by the media. And there's only some science that surfaces, right? And there's a lot of science that will come to the surface, but then they're being shadow banned or they're being censored in a way. And we're starting to see a lot of that with the COVID injections. We have doctors and virologists who are coming out and they're talking about the science behind it, and they're not allowed to speak if it doesn't correlate with the narrative that the mainstream media is portraying to the public, then it's less important, if you will. And childhood vaccinations are no different. There are a lot of parents who have lost children to childhood vaccinations. And then when they talk about it, their accounts are taken down. Sometimes the reports go unreported to the VAERS reporting system. So I think we as individuals have to start taking the initiative to start reporting the side effects ourselves. A lot of us don't know, including myself. I didn't know for a long time that at the VAERS adverse reporting system, which is VAERS.hhs.gov, that we as parents or we as individuals, if we have an adverse reaction to any vaccine, including the COVID injections, or if our children has a reaction to any vaccine, that we can report it if our doctors are not willing to report it for us.
That's very important for a lot of people to know, because I honestly don't think folks know what to do when their children or their themselves have reactions to vaccines. Let me ask you this: what can parents from either viewpoint expect to gain from the overall message of I'm Not Contagious?
Compassion. You know, this book is about having compassion about and on issues that aren't fully understood. Like I said before, this is not from my perspective. This is from a six-year-old's perspective. And he kind of gives like this whimsical, innocent perspective. And he has compassion for everyone. And so this isn't imposing one belief over the other. And there's actually a little scene in the in the book where, you know, my son, I have a friend, she and I both were pregnant at the same time. And she chose to vaccinate her child, where she knew where I stood and I chose not to vaccinate. But we're still friends. You know what I mean? Like, I don't judge her and she doesn't judge me. So my son and her son were born just a month apart. And there's a beautiful scene in the book where I'm dressed up like a superhero and she's dressed up like a superhero because we both want to protect our children. Regardless, you know, and we're both doing what we feel is best for our children without judging one another. And I think that's what this book is about. This book is about unity. This book is about having compassion on issues that aren't fully understood. And, you know, people may not agree completely with my decision. I may not completely agree with your decision, but it's okay. I know that you love your child just as much as I love mine. And that is the most important, because the ones who are being affected psychologically the most are our children.
Yeah.
And things are being said about our children. We have to remind ourselves, you know, we can't talk badly about one another, because children are going to hear that. Children need to know that their parents love them. Think about it like this. Think about when you have a mom and a dad who split up, right? Is it fair for the father to belittle the mother in front of the child? Imagine how that must make that child feel when the father is belittling the mother. When society does that, imagine how it does the same thing to the child psychologically.
Yeah, it's a really touch and go, challenging situation that we're in. But ironically, a lot of Americans are choosing to go holistic because we know that a lot of the ways that we were going previously have been causing us challenges with our health. And if you look at the trend, it's now going back to holistic, and there is no turning back, because people realize that everything that they've been ingesting in their body, the processed foods and drinks and all of the additives that are in the foods, they're causing challenges in the things that are the products and items that are being used to make just about everything that we're consuming. It is causing challenges. So I mean, I am all on the holistic. I'm not 100%, but I am moving that way. And the thing is, what people have to realize is that when you're so, your body is so used to process every and anything, you have to take it one step at a time. And then as you start ingesting more healthy items and just living more of a holistic pattern lifestyle, it's so amazing how quickly your body changes and starts to adapt to it. So let me ask you this right here. In the book there, you said there's puzzles and lessons that can assist the parents with knowledge. Can you talk about maybe one or two lessons and what the puzzles are that can help out? Because we're down to the last 5 minutes, and I want people to kind of understand a little bit more about the book and where they can get it from.
So, yeah, absolutely. So, you know, after writing this book, I realized that there was still so much that Grayson still didn't quite know. So I really wanted him to understand his basic human rights. So this is an introductory of, you know, learning your basic human rights that isn't taught in the school system. So I have a crossword puzzle at the back of the book. And it just touches on, like, you know, what is medical freedom? What is the 1986 Act? You know, what is medical tyranny? Things like that. You know, this is just, it allows for an open discussion to begin. It's something that the parents can sit down and do with their child together. I think it's very important to learn that, because they don't teach us this in the school system. And I even talk about the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. And when people go, I actually have like this thing that's going on right now where I'm offering a free book offer, and I make nothing off of it. So I'm just asking for people to cover the shipping and cover the cost of the book. And when anyone takes advantage of that offer, they're also going to get a free Freedom Warrior training video, and they're also going to get a Crusaders Tactics workbook. And that all goes, it's a whole lesson. So then they would be able to take that and answer the crossword puzzle at the back of the book. They'll also get a free coloring book. And also, Grayson made a book audio by himself. So I actually made that a part of his homeschool curriculum. And we used a program called Audacity. And so they'll get a behind the scenes video of how Grayson made the book audio, which I think is extremely, I'm so proud of him for how he took charge and just made this, because I was going to hire someone. And he looked at me and he said, "Mom, it's my voice. This book is from me. Like, why would you hire someone?" I said, "You know what? You know, you're right. What was I thinking?" So this right here is Asana. And I didn't have a sound booth, and I went on YouTube and I was trying to figure out like ways to create a sound booth. And I saw where someone had turned their sauna into a sound booth. So we laid down blankets and we turned this into like a little sound booth. So you'll see Grayson in there just taking charge and making the book audio.
Oh, that is so awesome. Guys, we've enjoyed our conversation with Miss Angela talking about her book that she created with her son, Grayson, I Am Not Contagious. Guys, we have enjoyed this time. We are out of time at this point. So I wanted to remind you guys, if you're just getting on, I'm Sandy White, your number one health and wellness cheerleader and the host of Simply Fit. We broadcast on WYTV7 Community Broadcasters Network at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So make sure you check your time zone so you don't miss any of our segments. So until next Wednesday, which is the day that we broadcast, we will see you guys later. And thank you, Ms. Angela, for coming on to the show.
Thanks so much for having me.
Hold your book up again.
I Am Not Contagious.